What's up, Wolfpack? Cole Gregg here out of Duthie Hill Mountain Bike Park to give you the rundown on the all-new Devinci Marshall. This is a 130mm rear, 140mm front trail bike that is aimed at beginner to intermediate riders. This is a bike that Devinci developed as an entry into mountain biking for many riders, as well as advanced riders that maybe are on a budget, as I found out that this bike actually rides really, really well. Today, we're gonna give you our long-term opinions on this bike. I've had it since, I believe February. I've gotten some time in it down in Arizona and up here in the Pacific Northwest. Duthie Hill here, in fact, was my favorite place to ride this bike. Tons of smooth single tracks, some fun jump trails, and just all around good pedal. Coming at $2,599 in the US, this bike features parts that you can rely on, that you can shred on, and also back to that lifetime warranty from Devinci, it's a really, really good value. So starting out with some of the frame specs, this is a 6061 T6 split pivot aluminum frame manufactured in Canada by Devinci. As far as sizing goes, there's sizes ranging from extra small to extra large. Our test bike here is a size large featuring 29-inch wheels, where the extra small and smalls come with 27.5-inch wheels. This size large features a 480mm reach, 1,227mm wheelbase with 435mm chainstays. Back up front, we have a 66.5 degree head tube angle, and for their seat tube angle, we're sitting right at 67.9. And the bottom bracket height comes in at 337mm. The size medium in this configuration comes in at 34.9 pounds, which is well respectable for a bike with this componentry and that aluminum frame. I found that the 480mm reach on this size large was spot on for my 6'1" height and incredibly long wingspan. I do believe anyone from 5'11 to 6'2" really on that size large could really get the most out of the frame. If you're a little bit under or over, I don't think this size range is gonna hurt you. 480mm is one of my favorite reach numbers. The seat tube angle on this Marshall is spot on as well. It gets you enough weight over your front wheel without having too much weight off the back. Me at 6'1" with super long legs, I always roll my dropper pretty far out, as you can see here, and it did not put me too far over the back on those steep, punchy climbs. All right, now that we've taken care of the Geo, let's move on to the build kit. Out back, you have a RockShox Deluxe Select R, and up front, you have a RockShox 35 Silver Edition. Now, this fork does not feature any compression adjustments other than that kind of three-tier lockout. I wouldn't suggest using this as a compression adjustment. It's really just a lockout, while out back, you just have a rebound adjustment. On steep climbing trails, I didn't find that I needed a lockout on this bike. A couple instances, I did turn the rebound down just to let it sit in a little bit, and it was just kind of a long fire road slog. But the split pivot design on this frame does pedal very efficiently. No unwanted crazy bob when you're in the saddle. Sure, when you get up and start putting the power down, you can really feel the bike kind of sit in, but it doesn't push you out. It really likes to sit into that travel. When it comes to getting your speed slowed down through those tight switchbacks, this bike features four-piston Shimano Dior M4100 levers and MT420 calipers paired with 180mm rotors front and back. Getting that power to the ground is a Shimano group set featuring a Dior M6100 12-speed derailleur and shifter paired with an MT510 crankset. Transferring all that power to traction, you have a set of 29mm internal width V2 comp wheels paired with some Formula MST hubs, finished off with a Maxxis DHR2 out back and DHF up front. Some other cool spec features on this bike is the double lip sealed enduro bearings, lifetime warranty, boost 12x148 rear spacing, and just the amount of bike you get for your money. I want to reiterate, this bike is for that intermediate beginner, first time mountain biker, maybe that semi-advanced guy that is on a budget that wants something he can go ride tomorrow and upgrade as he sees fit. In my time on this bike, I thoroughly enjoyed it on smoother single track mixed in with some shorter tight technical sections. You know, as an advanced rider, I can really outride this suspension. And when we were talking with Devinci about doing this review, it was like, hey, I'm gonna ride this bike on trails that I see the end consumer using it on. By no means can you not go ride this on gnarly stuff. It's just not gonna feel as good as your, you know, top of the line high spec bike. With that said, it does ride really, really well. Those super tight corners with the 435mm chainstays were not an issue at all to navigate. I found the bike super confident to manual. The balance point is really predictable. I would say one of my favorite things about this bike is that steep seat tube angle for longer climbs. Here at Duthie, there's not much elevation, so usually that seat is slammed down for jump trails. When it does come to getting airborne, the bike inspires confidence as any bike meant for that entry-level crowd should. There was no kind of awkward tendencies that I found. Getting used to the suspension and the different rebound tunes did take some getting used to, and I did spend quite a bit of time dialing in that air pressure and the rebound clicks. There's not a whole lot of them, but when you do make one click, it makes a big difference, so kind of playing back and forth really gives you a lot of feedback on the trail. Out of the box, there's really not a whole lot, you know, as an intermediate rider you want to change. I think as a more advanced rider, the one thing I actually would like to improve or change if this was my own bike would be the brakes. They are four piston, they're 180 millimeter rotors, but they do not quite have the power on super long steep descents. Again, this bike is not aimed at those riding those, you know, double black steep descents. While you can, and you gotta remember, it is only 130 mil out back, but you can get yourself into some steeper trails if you have the skill. Looking at what else is on the market in this price range, you do have a few other options, but this DaVinci, the way it rides, the characteristics, the kind of all around playful trail feel, the fun, easy tendency to want a manual, it's a really fun package, and I think there's a lot of riders out there coming from, say, a hardtail that could really benefit from a bike like this in their garage. All right, getting down to some of the nitty-gritty stuff, issues I had in this long-term test, the rear hub developed a little bit of play. I got in there and tightened it up and seems to be doing okay. Other than that, I haven't seen a ton of issues. With around 20K of descent on this bike, give or take a few thousand, the rear shock has started to develop a little oil buildup down at the base of the travel indicator. I'm not sure if this is something that is causing an issue. There's been no issues with compression or rebound or anything like that. It just developed a little bit of oil down at the end of the shock. The fork, however, has functioned flawlessly, no issues at all. This bike has been a joy to ride, especially here at Duthie. This place is a perfect area for beginner riders to develop their skills and advanced riders to come out and have a few fun hours after work riding some of the jump trails. A few final notes. I would say that as an advanced rider, I did outride the suspension. It could benefit down the road if it was mine going up to getting maybe a pike or some sort of burlier kit. I mean, this bike is not being held back by the frame in any means or my skill set. I mean, I rode it on all the trails here at Duthie. We have some pretty steep stuff at 27, and I scared the absolute crap out of myself down in Phoenix on some very sharp rocks. So yeah, overall, really, really fun bike. Definitely, if you are an intermediate to beginner level rider, or you're coming from a hardtail wanting to get into a short travel full suspension bike, put this one high on your list. Go throw a leg over it. You will not be disappointed. Thanks for tuning in. We really appreciate you taking the time to check out this review. Go ahead and subscribe if you haven't done so already for more videos coming soon. We love to hear your feedback. If you have any questions about this bike or maybe the terrain that it might be best suited for, go ahead and drop a comment below and I'll be sure to get back to you. Until then, we'll see you out on the trails.